Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the Jack and Deadpool show. So, we have received a lot of complaints that our previous episode was too violent for its own good. And, we are going to address those complaints and have a more family-friendly episode. So, today I'm going to teach you some education about driving. So, basically, whenever you're trying to stop your car to make sure you don't hit anybody, you have to make sure that whenever somebody is coming by and you are about to hit them, you have to stop. Whoa, that was close. So now, let's go over that situation again to see what happened if you didn't stop the car. So the car is going and you're driving around like la la la, you're blasting Marilyn Manson in your car or whatever the hell you like to listen to, I don't know. And then you see the car and you don't stop and you're like, oh God, I can't stop, no! And then you hit the car and you're like, oh my God, we're burning alive! I can't feel my pulse! And then a news reporter comes by and says, oh my God. And they're just puking their guts out, seeing everyone mangled in a horrible mess. All because you didn't press a single brake pedal on your car. Okay, Deadpool, you said you were trying to make this less violent and profane. You kind of made this a lot more violent than it should have been. Oh, really? You think just being real is too violent, Jack? This show's supposed to be for children, so kind of yes. Oh, you think this is real? You think this is real? Then take that. Here. You think it's so real? Why don't you eat it, Jack?
Don't let your kids watch it.
Thank you, Carl Stefan Carl. You know, Deadpool, you must really have a warped mind if this is what you really think children's entertainment is. Well, the thing is, Bonnie, children like insanity. Children like unhingedness. I know that, but that doesn't mean you should simulate a horrific car crash on camera and also try to murder your best friend using a toy car. He's not gonna be the only one I try to kill today, you carrot-nosed son of a- Oh. Who's at the door?
Hello, is this the house of, Freddy Fazbear?
Oh, are you here to talk about that one TV show episode? It's all this guy. He's kind of a psychopath.
Oh, no. Don't worry about that episode at all. I think you guys have great potential. So, if it's not too much to ask, can I take you guys to my studio, please?
Somebody pinch me right now. I have to be dreaming. You're gonna have to pinch me first, Deadpool.
Man, did you guys think it was possible to have an actual good plan to kill Freddy and his friends? I guess it is, but aren't we all dead?
You know how our monsters. We probably used the powers to bring everybody back somehow.
Except for those dinosaurs and that, Wreck-It Ralph guy.
Well, keep in mind, the dinosaurs are from an entirely different time period, and the Ralph guy is from an entirely different universe.
Whatever. Anyways, now that the Grinch is here, I think I have a song coming on.
Y'all a gross one, Mr. Grinch, yes you are. You are addicted to weedo. You have all the tender sweetness of a fat guy in a Speedo, Mr. Grinch.
You know, I kind of take that personally.
Given the choice between the two of you, I take the fat guy in a Speedo.
Okay, that's it. Come here, buddy.
Silence, you fools! For months, we have failed to take over this show and exterminate that filth that is Freddy Fazbear. But now, I have the perfect plan, and it is sure to work. We are going to make him and his friends famous, and then we are going to completely defame him by me using my powers so that absolutely nobody remembers him. And since nobody remembers him, no one will feel bad for him when he is killed.
Can I be the first to say that that's kind of a harsh fate?
It is not harsh in the slightest. I was back from the dead, and I was finally going to have my power back. But that bear and his friends took it all away from me in a flash. Freddy Fazbear has been spared for too long. We have been going too easy on him for the past season, but now we are going no relenting at all. He cannot be kept alive. He cannot keep getting away with letting our schemes be thwarted. Freddy Fazbear must be killed!
Oh, whoa, buddy. Now, look. I came to this because I was gonna get paid, and if all we're gonna do is defame him, then, well, it's fine. But killing him with nobody remembering him? No. I can't stand for this. This is too far.
If you refuse to comply, you agree to die.
What are you doing?
Listen here, you little ghost. You think I have the right to keep you alive? I have been going at this goal for far too long, and I've had enough of these trivial distractions. So, with your permission, I think it's safe to say that you have outlived any usefulness that you may provide to me and this cause for the rest of your f***ing life!
No, please, we can come to an agreement or something! No.
Anyone else on the side of him?
No, I think we're good, boss. Now, let's go kill Freddy and his friends! Yay!
Kermit, where did you come from?
I decided to, invite myself to this meeting. I have a score to settle with Deadpool.
What score?
Yeah, it's kind of personal. He owes me money.
Okay, guys, I think that we're here.
Welcome to the studio. Please, wait backstage for a second. We have to get the stage prepared for you and everything. Wait, the Grinch? Okay, one, how did you come back to life? And two, I still haven't forgiven you for paying me horribly. Deadpool, now's not the time. We're about to be on TV.
Yes, come right in. Right this way, sir.
Okay.
Good job, Grinch. And now, time to pull out the ultimate pot of this plan.
So, boss, what was that finger snap for? What did you end up doing? Oh, well, it's quite interesting, Kermit. You see, what I did was that I snapped my fingers so that absolutely nobody on Earth, except for his silly little friends on stage with him, remember who Freddy Fazbear is. And then, once I kill him, nobody will miss him. And his friends will live knowing that they're the only ones who remembered him. Wouldn't it be more fun if we just killed all five of them? Well, I mean, I guess it would, but it would be more cruel if I just left them alive, knowing that they're the only ones who remember Mr. Fazbear. Oh, this is gonna be fun to watch.
Stanley! Yeah, boss? Bring in his friends. Okay.
Am I the only one who feels like this couch gets more and more cramped as more episodes are made?
I don't know, Toy Freddy. Are you sure it's not more cramped because you're just getting fatter and fatter from all the Mountain Dew and Doritos you keep eating?
You're calling me fat? Buddy, look at your body. That is thick. That is a thick body right there, and you have the audacity to call me fat?
Yes, I do.
I'll be right back. Hey, Pillow Freddy, he called you chunky.
No, please! Help me!
Oh, God! Stop! Get me out of here, please!
Guys, what's going on here?
Nothing.
No, I mean, I don't have a problem with that. I mean, I know some people would pay good money to see that. Can somebody help me, please?
What do you want, Stanley? Are you coming here to mess with us again?
Yeah, matey. Every time you've been coming here, it's just nothing but trouble. What do you want?
No. Look, first of all, I want to apologize for trying to kill you in the past few episodes. It's kind of a crappy thing to do, especially since I used to hang out with, some of you guys. A lot of you guys were introduced, after I left the show, but, yeah. Anyway, Freddy and his friends are on TV now.
Who's Freddy?
What are you talking about? Remember? You used to date him?
I'm not even in a relationship right now.
Come on, anybody know who Freddy is? You know, Candy Cadet, he's the master of your house, you're his butler.
No, I am the butler of Bonnie and Foxy. I do not know what you are talking about when you say Freddy. Remember Candy and Pop Goes? Your games are inspired by his games? I thought our games were just original properties, man.
Yes, it worked.
Okay, guys, anyway, come on to the studio. You'll get to see the other guys. Well, let's go.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for attending today's show. Now, I will note that the following program is being recorded in front of a live audience. So I will ask you to silence all cell phones and other electronic devices and—
Hey, turn off your cell phone!
Hey, chill out, matey. It's the cell phone that's recording the show.
Oh, my apologies. The show will start right now, so take one. Action.
I don't know about this, Freddy. I kind of get stage fright.
Bonnie, you perform in a camera all the time. You've been doing this for, like, nearly 5 years at this point.
But, Freddy, I don't know what to say.
Here, Bonnie, just pretend the audience is naked, and it won't be so scary.
Okay,
You are all naked!
Oh, okay, Bonnie, I didn't mean for you to inform the audience that they're all naked.
Hey,
get this clown off stage! Not we're to all get naked anyway! By some clown.
Guys, this guy sucks!
Yeah, we're get adults here! Stage. We deserve to get kicked around!
Sorry, we're stopping the show real quick. Cut. We're experiencing technical difficulties. Bonnie! Foxy, Jack, and Deadpool, come into my office.
Did we do something wrong, sir?
Oh, don't worry. It's quite the contrary, actually. You see, whenever I watched you on stage today, Bonnie, the way you acted so defiant towards Freddy, it sparked an interest in my heart for you and those guys. Yeah, those guys, too. Not to be crass about it, but I mean, you guys can be franchise characters. Like, you could be up there with, like, Bugs Bunny or Mickey Mouse or Batman or Super Mario Brothers. That's how popular you guys could be.
Great, we'll go get Freddy.
No, forget about Freddy. Did you see how the public reacted to him? That little buzzkill ruining that golden joke with you saying, "You are all naked!" Like, come on, that was such a good joke. And he just had to ruin it right there.
It wasn't a joke. I actually had stage fright. He was just comforting me because, I mean, he's Freddy. He's a good friend and everything. Like, why can't you bring him along? He's a good guy. He'll provide you some good public press so that you'll have some good publicity and everything.
Forget about Freddy. Now listen, I got a limousine outside waiting for you guys. It's for a party for your success. Now come on, we'll leave Freddy here, and he can watch jealous, because he has no talent, unlike you guys. Now come on.
I guess we better go, guys.
Wait, guys, where are you going? You forgot about me. Wait, guys! Guys! Please don't go.
Hey, boss. I thought we were just gonna kill them, but I mean, leaving one of them alive with nobody remembering him, that's kind of a harsh fate.
I did what had to be done.
No, you did what you thought had to be done, when really, that's not what we should have done to begin with. I mean, they might have killed me a bunch of times, but I come back every episode, and now that I think of this, all of this doesn't matter. You know what, guys? I quit. Who's with me?
I think we all are with you, Kermit. Yeah, even I have to agree the MySpace thing doesn't even matter now.
So you, whoever the hell you are, can take this plan of yours and shove it.
How dare you speak to me in this manner?
But you know what? It's fine. You have outlived your usefulness.
Come here!
Everybody, run!
No, we stay right here.
Oh no, we're stuck!
Quick, open the door, open the door!
Where are we gonna go? I don't know. I don't know. I think we should just hide here. Alright, I think we lost him.
Think again.
My god, man, he's bad with power.
I know.
The door is bolted shut, but how are we gonna get out of here?
I know. We'll hide behind him.
What?
Just trust me on this one.
Oh, this is so stupid.
Hello there.
No!
Well, hello, Shining Man.
Glad I still have some people that are loyal to me. Now come on, we gotta go make things worse.